Good morning and welcome to worship at Clarkson Road Presbyterian Church. We welcome the Clarkson family and our brothers and sisters in Christ from North Bramalea, where I am the interim moderator. And we offer a special welcome to everyone who is joining us today. It is so good to be together as God's people to worship God. And we say Happy Father's Day to those who are fathers and grandfathers and those who play a mentoring and fathering role in the lives of others. Happy Father's Day, enjoy your day. I'd invite you to visit our website. We have a resource there for, there's a children's bulletin with puzzles and coloring, and there's a lovely devotion there as well that you might enjoy doing. And we're going to have more resources coming up there for the summer, and all of our summer bulletins will be appearing shortly for kids. As we come to worship this morning, I invite you to just take a couple of deep breaths. Just settle in. This gives you a chance to just center and remember that wherever you are coming to worship the Lord. If you have a candle in your space, I invite you to light that candle as a reminder that Christ's light continues to shine in the world and shines through you into the world. As we come to worship this morning, our call to worship is based on Psalm 86, which is the psalm that we will hear read later today. Our God is a God of compassion and mercy, slow to get angry, and filled with unfailing love and faithfulness. So come, let us worship God together, for great is his love toward us. We're going to begin by singing the church's One Foundation.
The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ our Lord. We are his new creation by water and the blood. From him he came and sought us that we might ever be his living servant people. By his own death set free.
come to the Lord with our prayers of adoration, confession, and the Lord's Prayer. Please pray with me. God of grace, you created our minds to grow in wisdom. You created our hearts to expand with love for you and for your world. You created our voices to sing your praises forever. Fill us to overflowing with your Holy Spirit, so that we may worship you in spirit and in truth, bold and unafraid to follow you. Jesus, you showed us what it means to love, and you lived your life and went about your ministry. You showed us what it means to love others. You showed us that there are no caveats to loving. Everyone is worthy, and everyone is in need of your love. Jesus, you showed us what sacrificial, unconditional love looks like when you went to the cross and died so that we might live. Thank you. You have entrusted us, and indeed commanded us, to live and love like you did. We're your hands and feet in this world. God, we have to confess that we like to think that we're all about love and that we know how to love. But if we take an honest look at our lives, we have to confess that we have biases and we have blind spots. Give us the wisdom and the courage to see these, and help us to confess the ways that they impede us to love. Forgive us when we don't love fully. We ask this as we pray together now in the way that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I offer you these words of love and forgiveness. In Christ, we are made a new creation. The old life is gone and the new has come. Know that God loves you and forgives you. Don't be afraid to have a fresh start.
Prayer for illumination. God of wisdom, by the power of your Holy Spirit, open our minds to your truth, our hearts to your gospel, and our hands so that we can do your will. In the name of Jesus, your living word, we pray. Amen. Now reading Psalm 86. Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and needy. Preserve my life, for I am devoted to you. Save your servant who trusts in you. You are my God, be gracious to me, O Lord. For to you I cry all day long. Gladden the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. For you, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call on you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer. Listen to my cry of supplication. In the day of my trouble I call on you, for you will answer me. There is none like you among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any works like yours. All the nations you have made shall come and bow down before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. For you are great and do wondrous things. You alone are God. Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. Give me an undivided heart to revere your name. I give thanks to you, O Lord my God, with my whole heart, and I will glorify your name forever. For great is your steadfast love towards me. You have delivered my soul from the depths of Sheol. O God, the insolent rise up against me. A band of ruffians seek my life, and they do not set you before them. But you, O Lord, are a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. Turn to me and be gracious to me. Give your strength to your servant. Save the child of your servant girl. Show me a sign of your favor, so that those who hate me may see it and be put to shame, because you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me.
Reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. And as for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these is love.
Thank you so much, Samantha and Chloe. It was lovely to see you and to hear you read the scriptures this morning. Thank you. I speak to you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. These last few months have made me think about love an awful lot. As we've been living through this pandemic and not able to be with those who are outside of our household, no doubt we've all thought a lot about those that we love and how difficult it is when we can't be together, and just how much we want to hug those that we love. During this time of social distancing, we as a community of faith have been trying to make sure that people connected know that they're loved and feel loved. And we've tried to share love with our community as well. My reflections about love became more complicated. And they went in a different direction and took on new depths with the death of George Floyd. His words, "I can't breathe," have stuck with me. The subsequent protests and rallies continue to cry out for change, and they've made me consider how we as followers of Jesus Christ can respond in the way that the church can make a difference. How do we make the gospel come alive? How do we make the kingdom of God, the way that God intended the world to be, become that much more real now? Love, of course, is the foundation for all of these reflections and our actions. The scriptures have an awful lot to say about love. And today we're going to look at the famous love passage from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. This passage, a poem really, is so familiar, and we often think of it as the wedding passage. Even people who don't go to church know this passage a little bit because they've heard it so many times at weddings. It speaks a truth about love, and there's so much there that we like to grab onto, but this passage is not about romantic love. This isn't at all what Paul had in mind when he wrote this letter to the people of Corinth. Paul is looking at the meaning, purpose, and necessity of love within that Corinthian community. We don't have to go very far in this letter to figure out that Paul is writing to the people of Corinth about the divisions that are evident in their community. In fact, it's the 10th verse of the first chapter where Paul appeals to his brothers and sisters to agree with one another so that there may be no divisions among you, and that you may be perfectly united in mind and thought. Paul is not looking for a happy, clappy kind of unity, not at all, but Paul is looking for a unity that can be there amid differences. There is an authenticity to what he is writing about. And after this plea, Paul spends most of the next 9 chapters addressing the divisions that center around worship, marriage, and lawsuits among the believers. Paul leads into this chapter on love by saying, "I will show you a still more excellent way." So let's look at this love chapter in light of it speaking into a communal way of living, a better way to be the body of Christ. In the first stanza, we see Paul using a formulaic pattern to get his point across. If I have this but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. I am nothing. I gain nothing. In this stanza, Paul writes of some of the impressive things that believers can be empowered by the Holy Spirit to do. Speaking in tongues, having prophetic powers to speak into mysteries, and giving away possessions. All of these things are admirable. But if they are not anchored in the love of God, made known in Jesus Christ, they are nothing. They do not matter. Without love, who we are and what we do doesn't matter. Paul then moves into saying what love is and isn't. And he's very specific and concrete in what he says. And I'm going to read this part to you again. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. This is the type of love that the Holy Spirit enables us to cultivate and offer. And if we're honest, we can each admit that it's not always easy to live into those things. In the third stanza, Paul writes of the depth of this enduring love. Other things pass away, but love endures. Love lives beyond finite time and space. Love has the capacity to help us live in community, in unity, even while differences exist. A spotlight has been shone into our differences and how we are interconnected and interdependent in these last months. Grocery store clerks have become our heroes. And as the world begins to open up and more businesses get back into doing business, and we consider group activities, we have to consider how we'll do these things. How does love provide a foundation for what we do? The death of George Floyd also put a spotlight on racism, differences, and unity. The call to be different and to live differently is loud and persistent. It's going to require a foundation of love And we can look to Paul's writing to help us in that. The Bible tells us the way that people will know that we are followers of Jesus Christ is by the way that we love one another. Jesus says in the Gospel of John that he gives a new commandment, that we love one another. Just as Jesus has loved us, we also should love one another. And by this, everyone will know that we are Jesus' disciples, if we have love for one another. This is a time for self-reflection, for listening and learning. This is a time for us to be in conversation with one another. This is a time for us to live out the gospel. There are no simple answers. There's no easy way to get to them either. So I invite you to spend a little bit more time in the love chapter, 1 Corinthians 13. Reflect on St. Paul's writing. There is a lot there. In what ways do you see Jesus in these writings? How are you living out what Paul says about love? Are there particular areas that are challenging for you? Perhaps there's some that you can right away say, I'm not good at that. I'm better at this part. And then let's consider, how do we live in love in our current world, in our current society, in light of this writing? The reflection might be challenging to do, but it's so important that we do it. The time has come for change. And we, as Christ followers, need to be part of that. God bless you in your reflection and in the ways that you make love the foundation to all of your life. The hymn, Brother, Sister, Let Me Serve You, is a hymn that speaks of this kind of love. Let's sing together.
Yeah.
The season of Pentecost, which we are still in, celebrates the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and it energizes the church to touch the world with God's love and mercy, God's truth and justice. Whatever we offer back to God becomes a gift which can change the world for the sake of Jesus Christ. We are grateful for your ongoing support of our ministry and mission, and I would just like to take the opportunity to remind you that we are offering a special gift to Compass families this summer, and we've begun a special collection to buy soccer balls for the families. And so for $13, you can buy a soccer ball for a family, and they'll have loads of fun with that this summer. E-transfer or dropping a check off to the church or sending one in the mail is the easiest way to support that. Let's offer our prayer of dedication for all the many gifts. O God, you are kind and generous to us, and we offer our gifts to you in gratitude. Pour your Spirit out on these gifts and on our lives so that your love flows through all that we do and into every life that we touch. We offer these gifts in the name of Jesus Christ, the living Lord. Amen. As we come to pray for the world and people, I remind you that our prayer team is active and praying. If you have prayer requests, please send them to me and I will pass them on, and we will actively pray for your needs. Let's pray together now. Loving God, on this Father's Day, we give thanks for fathers and all the men who play a fatherly role in our lives. We pause now, and in the quiet of this moment, we offer you our thanks for our fathers. Gracious God, this day can be so difficult for many people. And we honor these feelings. We pray for those whose longing for a relationship with their father went unfulfilled. We pray for situations where relationships are fractured or filled with tension. We pray for those who bear the scars of a relationship that didn't come close to the fatherly love that you exhibit. And we lift up to you those whose fathers are no longer on this earth, and they grieve. Lord, we pray that whatever emotions this day raises for us, we remember that you are our Heavenly Father. You love us beyond our imagining. You celebrate with those who celebrate, and you compassionately sit with those who find this day difficult. On this Indigenous Sunday, we pray for our Indigenous brothers and sisters. We confess our part and the part of the Presbyterian Church in Canada in harming these people. Inspire us to learn more about their history, culture, and current situations. Help us as a society and church to continue to work toward fulfilling the recommendations of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission. As spring officially turns to summer, we are reminded of just how different this summer will be without so many of the activities that we were looking forward to. We pray for all the children who move from homeschooling to more time at home. Thank you for churches and church camps that are finding ways to give kids a camping experience in a very different way this year. We pray for the staff of our Presbyterian camps, Karen and Kintail, for the creative and innovative ways they are supporting families and offering fun activities for campers. We also pray for Clarkson Community Church, formerly Chartwell Baptist, who are taking SAGA online this summer. And they have a great lineup of activities. God, we ask that you would bless the staff and the campers. Let these new experiences draw people to you. Ever-present God, as we move into the next steps of the pandemic, we pray for safety as we begin to open more businesses and partake in more gatherings. Give us the fortitude to do what we can to keep ourselves and others safe. Continue to uphold leaders as they make the decisions that are in the best interest of all in society and our economy. Be with healthcare workers. So many are exhausted and carrying heavy burdens from all that they've been through. Comfort and heal their emotional, physical, and spiritual wounds. There are so many things to pray for these days. We've touched on a few. But we know, God, and we trust that you hear the prayers that come from our hearts, even those that we can't find the words to pray. We pray all of these things in the name of Jesus, who prays with us. Amen. We go out today singing, "I'm Going to Live So God Can Use Me." Let's sing together.
I'm gonna live so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna live so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna work so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna work so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna pray so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna pray so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna sing so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. Sing so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna live so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime. I'm gonna live so God can use me anywhere, Lord, anytime.
Go now to love and serve in Jesus' name. And as you go, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the friendship and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you and those that you love and pray for on this day and forevermore. Amen.